Today is the day. These extensions are coming out. I made the executive decision that I am ready to go back to natural hair. My natural hair is actually pretty long, so this is where it's at. But if you guys remember, I had it cut to like here, so it's grown that much. But I got extensions because it was kind of at an awkward length and I was ready to go back long. And the girls did such a good job. I go to the salon here in Atlanta called Kate Barone Salon, if you haven't heard me talk about them yet, but they are like extension gurus in Atlanta, and they also specialize in like, just like, I don't even know how to explain it, just really modern type coloring techniques. And it's not even techniques, they're just really good at like creating like a color, like the highlights and the balayage that I have. That's like super modern and super cool. So they just do really cool things there at that salon. And I really wanted to try, like I've never been a very like high maintenance hair girl. Like I literally had my hair cut twice a year. I had never had it dyed. Like I never wore extensions. Like I never did anything. And then last year I decided to chop it all off because I just wanted to try something new. Why not? And this year I wanted to add extensions because I wanted to try something new. So I think what I'm gonna do now is just kind of go back to my like natural state, which is gonna be like darker. So this is, let me turn you around, hold on. It'll be like darker, probably back more to my natural hair color. And I'm just gonna take the extensions out. So it'll be not as full, definitely shorter because my hair goes to here now. But I'm excited. The reason I'm taking them out is because I started working out really hard recently, and I mean, it's no like surprise that extensions are a ton of maintenance. Like washing them and drying them for me took probably over an hour, which is just coming from somebody who literally had no maintenance to somebody who has an hour's worth of work daily is like not just a big jump. So I'm ready to go back to like being more low maintenance with my hair, but of course I'm still going to Kate because I literally don't trust anybody else with my hair. I've tried so many people here in Atlanta when I first moved here just because, I don't know, I just like wasn't tied to anyone, and literally I feel like everybody messed them up except for Kate, and I literally was only getting a trim. Like I wasn't even doing anything crazy. So that's why I just only go to Kate, because it's just stressful to go to anywhere else. We come to grips with our wrists. We come to sound with our mouths. We sing of what we think we know. Mother fire, skin and flood. And we move just like the birds. Moving amidst the other birds. And we move just like the fish. Rolling away from larger. And I know I'm projecting the line I'm lacking. But oh, you look like a morning star. Okay guys, we just finished painting upstairs. Finally, like it's taken so long. And the reason is because we had to paint the shutters. I have to show you, we're in my basement right now. It's like kind of creepy down here, hold on. So Taylor set up this like whole workspace to spray shutters. Stuck. So he set up this whole workspace in our basement. It's unfinished, thank God we have all the space, but it proved to be an extremely tedious job because he did all these by himself. I wasn't even in here helping him spray. So what he did was, well, first of all, we kind of leaned them out and numbered them from where they went upstairs. And then he added these like screws at the top and at the bottom. And then also the sides. So he could use these screws to help flip them when they were on the sawhorses. So he sprayed them right here. Taylor, do you want to give any more information?
Look at my ankles. I got white ankles.
You guys should see his other pair of shoes. It's like kind of crazy. I'll show them to you in a second. But yeah, he did 14 shutters. He sprayed them the Collingwood color from Benjamin Moore. And then he did all of our shelves that go into like the shelving situation and the doors for the shelves. Like, I'll go upstairs and show you in just a second. Oh, and then I forgot to mention, we're like going full on monochrome. So we even sprayed, these are kind of wet, so I don't want to touch them, right?
They're tacky.
Is it okay if I touch them?
I mean, I'm holding four of them.
Okay. So we even sprayed the brackets. Are these called brackets?
Hinges.
Hinges. That go, like, to hold the shutters up. So it's all going to be completely monochrome, which really speaks to my heart. Oh, before I go upstairs, these are Taylor's shoes. These used to be white, but now they're the gray, beige color.
You know what? Hold on.
All right, here we are. All of our mainly Taylor's hard work. Look at this fireplace. It looks so good. We're gonna paint the inside black too, so it'll be, as our friends like to call it, murdered out. And then just white. Obviously, it's like super messy in here, so sorry about that. Taylor's so excited, he wants to get the first two up, but pretty tired, I want to go to bed soon. So this is what Hobbs has been doing. We had a minor scare with Hobbs today. Also, I don't know how he got my white sweater down. It was like up there on the couch, and he somehow maneuvered it down so he could sleep right on top of it. So it looks like I'm washing that. But anyway, he got into the fire pit. We were like burning some wood outside in our backyard. And there was ash in there, and he ended up getting into it and eating a bunch of ash and threw up like 5 times. He started shaking. He wouldn't eat his dinner. So naturally, I freaked out and Googled everything. And probably the worst thing to do, because Google has like basically like your dog's gonna die. It's literally, that's what it was saying. And so I was freaking out. But the vet said he's fine. He's just gonna be nauseous for a few days. So, do you feel okay to bed?
Ow! Do not bite my foot. Stop.
I forgot to film. Oh God. So we've been moving what was all in this like. Hold on. Hobbs is barking. I apologize. I literally have zero makeup on. It's like Sunday, but we are moving everything that was in this room into this den area. And every time we do anything with the rugs, like roll them up and roll them back out, Hobbs goes psycho. I don't know why, but he just goes absolutely psycho. Anyway, so we... We're about to, I can't even concentrate with him in here, but we're about to move all of this stuff into this den area. And just to give you an update on the couch that's going to go in here, we just got confirmation on everything, like the order, the financials, like everything looks good for the new couch, except for we just need to finalize the color. So soon we'll have a new couch in here, but for now, the stuff is going in there. And now he's relaxed. Are you a psycho? Now he's worn out. All right guys, so we put this room together. Taylor's already watching the game. It just feels so cozy in here. And this room is now officially empty. I feel like Hobbs is confused because we keep moving things around. Now I am about to go get ready for a shoot with Allie. Okay guys, I am about to go shoot with Allie. That brand hired me again from the last shoot, or the last few vlogs ago. I posted that this brand sometimes hires me to just shoot some looks for their website that Allie shoots, and then she sends some high-res images, which is really fun. So I'm about to go shoot their fall collection. And yeah, that's what we're doing today. So then I'm gonna come back and relax on the couch. And I know you're protecting the liar lacking, but oh, you look like a morning star. see we are alive. You look good in the west, see how you cut those ends. You look good in the south, see how you use your mouth. You look good in the east, our elbows and knees. To the honey dipper. Morning, guys. It is Saturday morning, and Taylor last night had gone to Costco and he got this like pancake mix that you can also obviously do waffles, and we've decided we wanted to do waffles today and we don't have a waffle maker, so I just came to Target just to grab a waffle maker and just a few other items. We never eat like pancakes and waffles, but recently they've just sounded really good, so we're gonna make some. I think we're gonna put like strawberries, and I personally want to do like real whipped cream. Like, I'm gonna try and make my own like real whipped cream. Taylor doesn't eat that stuff, he's like super healthy, but I just want to try it. It's Saturday, so why not? So I'm gonna go get a waffle maker, so that's what we're doing here today. All right, these are the waffle makers. Now I just have to make a decision. I feel like I want ones that turn like this. Can't decide. I've actually been thinking about a waffle maker for a while now. How do you open this? Ah. All right, so this is the pancake mix that we're using from Costco. It's like paleo. It's supposed to be healthier. It's with almonds, coconut, cassava, eggs, and monk fruit. Low glycemic and dairy free. So it just says just add water. So Taylor's doing that right now. All right, so I was about to make my whipped cream that I wanted to make in our KitchenAid stand mixer, and we noticed it was leaking like all this oil. And I was looking at YouTube videos on how to fix this, and basically he said we don't use it enough. So now I have to replace the oil in it. So I'm like learning how to like take the back off, but I don't have the oil that I need to replace, I guess, the oil that's like in this compartment. So I gotta go to Lowe's and get that, but now I gotta clean this up because that's so gross. All right, so now I have to make this whipped cream that I was really excited about by hand, which I guess that's like the best way to do it anyway. It's just a lot of work, so I gotta get the whipping cream. So Taylor and I have been cooking up the storm today. Oh, these look really good.
I think they're almost done.
And we just got out the air fryer that his parents got us, and yeah, those look good. Hobbs. Now, I don't know. This is our setup. I know it's like so messy, but we have our little fire going. Hobbs is just laying by it, and I was actually trying to get a video of him laying because it was like the most heartwarming thing I've ever seen, but he got up. But I did want to show you guys this. My sister-in-law, Tori, had this the other day, and I saw her like carrying it with water or whatever she was drinking, and I was obsessed, and I wanted to get one. I saw this at Target today, so of course I bought it, but I'm obsessed with it. It just like keeps everything cold. It's big. And it like can go into a normal drink holder. So I'm a huge fan of this. I keep telling Taylor it's my favorite purchase, and he keeps laughing at me because I always buy like drink cup holders, but that one's a good one. You like the fire? Hey guys, I left my vlogging camera at home, but I meant to vlog this part of my day. So I'm going into West Elm right now. I have to give some background on, I feel like I need to back up for a second. So we got our final, Taylor and I have been searching for a couch to put in like the main living space, the one that's like, has the tall ceilings, and it's the one that has like the IKEA Besta unit that's like up on the wall. So my whole vision with that room is I wanted one big couch room. So like just a couch that was deep and super comfy and just like was the main piece of furniture in that room. Like I didn't want a bunch of small things. I wanted one like big substantial piece. So we were working on getting a custom couch. It basically looked like the cloud couch, but it was not the cloud couch. It was custom built to fit our space exactly. And we have been working with this company and they seem to be great. They seem to know what they're doing, but these just like weird fees started popping up, and the total ended up being just slightly higher than our initial thought it was gonna be. And this includes discounts because I was gonna work with them on some videos. I'm here at West Elm right now because I found another couch online at West Elm that pretty much looks like what we're looking for. I just want something super angular, like not a lot going on, very minimal. And they have a really cool couch online that looks comfortable. So hopefully they have it in store, but I'm mainly here just to look at the fabric samples. So I'm gonna go look at that and I will take you guys with me on my iPhone because I forgot my vlog camera, but let's go in and figure it out. So this is the couch. Okay guys, so back on my actual camera, my vlog camera. I made Taylor come with me after work, so I'd stopped earlier to get some fabric samples, and I didn't pick up the one that I actually wanted, which is kind of dumb for me, but sorry, Hobbs is chewing a bone. So anyway, I made Taylor come with me after work to go back to West Elm because the sale, they're having a what's it called, Columbus Day sale today. So I wanted to order the couch today because it's on sale. I think it's like 20% off. So we picked up the sample that I wanted, and now we are about to, now we are about to tape out the couch. So I think we are gonna have it go a little bit longer just because we're gonna buy like another section to put. It all makes sense when it comes, but we had to buy another section to extend it a bit, just so it fits this room. My vision of one big couch room is about to come to life. I'm so excited. All right, so we didn't like tape it all out, but at least you can kind of see where the back part of the couch would go. And then this is where the front. Couch is officially ordered. So excited. I also wanted to show you guys, we got two of our 6 kitchen chairs in. Please ignore all that. That's literally been sitting here. Been trying to do my painting video and I just haven't done it yet. These are what they look like. I love them. I feel like they look super minimal. And I really like the curved back. I just thought this was just a really cool design. I'm pretty sure the price point was really good for these also. I think it was like, I wanna say like $230 per chair, which Taylor would not agree with me that that's a very good price, but I talked him into it. I feel like these are really cute. Hey guys, I had to share this with you because I have been living this way since fall started and the sun like changes patterns throughout the day. Anyway, so I have been trying to get Taylor to hang these IKEA, these curtain tracks for, I don't even know how long. It's been I've ordered them, like I've had them since I think May or March, maybe June. I don't know, I have no idea. But I really want them to hang my these curtain tracks that go to the ceiling so that I have a little bit of privacy, but also like will filter the light when I'm shooting in here. More importantly, I have to show you how annoying this is. Obviously this is where I work. All of my stuff is right there. So when I'm sitting here working, I mean, can you guys see this? It's just like beating down on my face. Like you can't even see me because the sun is so bright behind me. But it's like really hard to focus because I can barely see my screens. I like anytime I get on a Zoom call, this is what I look like. Like literally, it's just so bad. So I've been trying to convince Taylor to hang those for me because I have no idea what I'm doing. I honestly don't know what I would do without Taylor. Like I guess I would figure it out and hire a handyman, but maybe do it myself, I don't know. But he's just so much better at all this stuff. So I'm just waiting on him. Hopefully I can convince him to do it tonight. So that's about it. But right now I do have a mask in my hair. I did one of the Olaplex masks. I don't do them. I used to do them more when I had my extensions in because I felt like my extensions were a little dry, mainly because I was getting the highlights at that point. Now I'm back to my darker color. But yeah, I do a mask probably every other week. It's been longer than that recently, but when I had my extensions in, I did it once a week, sometimes twice a week. So yeah, that's where I'm at today. But I'm really excited about the couch that we ordered last night. I feel like this is going to be such a good thing. I don't know if you guys do this. I have to get back to work, but this is just kind of like a rant that I was thinking about. I used to have this weird view of West Elm. Like I know it just sounds so dumb, but I somehow just like viewed it as like very commercialized and like kind of cheesy. And please don't come at me for saying that. I literally have no reason to think that. Like it actually, they do have really good stuff. I went to the store yesterday, obviously, to get the fabric samples for the couch. But the point of me saying that is I'm so excited for this couch that we ordered. I feel like it's such a good shape. West Elm has completely surprised me. And I may be turning the corner on my thought about them. So let me know, does anyone else kind of feel that way with West Elm or is it just me? So let me know in the comments below, but I might be changing my mind on it. I didn't think this day would ever come. Taylor's finally hanging my curtain wrap or curtain track.
I'd rather be watching Auburn lose.
I'm sure you would. But the sun is like beating. Oh. Also, I don't think I've shown you guys this yet. Oh, just kicked my nail with my glasses. You can't really see. I feel like the sun's like making this look really dark, but Hobbs has a cone. This poor bud has to be wearing a cone for a few days. His eye got scratched. We believe like one of his thumbnails when he was trying to like itch his face, scratched his eye. So he has like a gash in his eye and the doctor said it wasn't like super deep, thank goodness, but we are treating it with eye drops currently. It looks like it's getting better, but he still has to wear this cone for a bit. So I feel so bad for him. They are officially up. I'm so excited. Super minimal, exactly what I wanted. You can't even tell that it's up there except for obviously you'll see the curtains hanging down. Somebody asked me on Instagram, which I thought was kind of funny. They're like, is this something new that I've never seen before, hanging a curtain rod in front of crown molding? And maybe it might be new, but all of the inspo pictures that I've been saving have no crown molding. So if it were up to me, I would rip out every single piece of crown molding in this house, but that's super expensive and like kind of unnecessary. So I think it's fine to put the track in front of the crown molding. I don't see any difference than as if it wasn't there. I'll show you, like there's not really a huge gap comparatively. Like if you were to have a curtain rod anyway, it would stick out from the wall so that your curtains don't rub against your window anyway. So I feel like this is exactly what I wanted. I think it looks really, really good. Also, if you want to know, well, first of all, these curtains are way too short, so just ignore that. This is just all I have right now, so I'm trying to figure out what curtains to put up. But for now, I'm just going to put these up because the reason is because this window, the sun just beats in that I just really need something up like right away. But if you want to know why I'm like wrapping it around in this corner, I saw a picture on Instagram that I thought was really cool that had curtains. They were like sheer, and it was the whole wall that had curtains and then it wrapped around the corner, which I thought was so cool and a little unexpected. So I wanted to do that in here, just recreate it. Just because this is my like office studio space, I just figured like I kind of have free reign to be creative and do whatever I want in this room. So that's why I wanted to do that with this. And I'm excited to get these up. Okay guys, the blinds are up. So these are temporary. Sorry, let me put my phone down. Temporary blinds, or I'm sorry, why do I keep saying blinds? Curtains. And because they're not long enough, obviously, but I think what I'm gonna do is potentially make my own. I just need to go to the fabric store and make sure I can find some fabric that I like, which I'll probably just do similar fabric to this that's like sheer. These are from IKEA. It's two separate panels. So my goal would actually to have a panel that's just that wide, but it's one panel, it's not two separate ones. So it wouldn't be disconnected like that. And then I need to put some on this side as well. So I've been waiting to see if this tree outside my window will change colors. And it looks like it's on its way. I don't know if you can see that because the sun's kind of blinding right now, but it's actually starting to lose some leaves at the top. So I don't know if it'll just like lose all its leaves before it changes, but it's so pretty. Hey guys, so I'm signing off for this, I say week's vlog, but I've been recording I think over like 2 or 3 weeks because I just forget to record enough to put in a vlog, so I just kind of have been recording when I remember. But I am trying to get better at vlogging and moving any like, I guess casual conversation type thing that I've been having onto my weekly vlogs, or I want it to become weekly. I don't want to promise that just yet because it's been hard to get any of them up, but I'm hoping to move more of my like everyday life onto my vlogs and just post like finished product onto Instagram. So that's kind of the plan, but I hope you guys are liking these. I know a few of you have been asking for them, so I'm so grateful for that, that I'm actually providing any sort of entertainment or value or whatever it is that you like to watch in a vlog. So if there's anything that you do like watching in a vlog, I would love to know that, just because I'm kind of just doing them because they're fun to create, but I'm always down for more feedback if you guys have that. So I will leave it at that, but I hope you guys are having a really great week, and I will see you on my next video.